Hello everyone. In this video, I'm going to teach you how to install firmware into an Android phone. Before I can install firmware into an Android phone, let me show you how this phone behaves. Have you been in a situation where you turn your phone on and it hangs on the boot plug and it doesn't proceed? It hangs there for forever. That is called a boot loop. A boot loop, it is when your phone is stuck on the boot logo and doesn't go past that logo. That can be fixed by installing a new firmware in your phone or tablet. Okay, what I'm going to do right now, I'm gonna open a tool called SP Flash Tool. This is a tool used to flash MTK-based Android phones. There are different types of phones, or let me say Android phones. This one is MTK based. All right, as you can see, this phone keeps on rebooting. So what I'm gonna do right now, I'm gonna load firmware using the MTK or SP Flash tool. Apart from the driver that's required in order to install firmware, you also need to download the firmware itself. Okay, let me remove the battery. To switch it off. All right. Apart from the driver, another thing you need is a firmware itself. So you need about three things. The first thing is the SP Flash tool that is used to load the firmware. The second thing is the firmware itself. Then lastly, you need the driver software. What the drivers do, they initiate communication between your phone and your computer via USB cable. Without the driver, the phone will not be detected. Then the SP Flash tool is used to load the firmware. After downloading the firmware, you need to select Scada loading file and click here. Then you can navigate to the directory where your firmware is. Right now, the firmware I have is Mobicel Onyx, and this phone is Mobicel Onyx too. You need to download the right firmware for the phone you're about to flash. Otherwise, you might damage your phone. Damaging a phone using a different firmware or software that is not required or that is not supported is called soft brick, and that can damage your phone to the point where it can no longer be fixed. Right now I have Mobicel Onyx, so I'm gonna click here on Mobicel Onyx, then firmware, then I'll click the Scada file. When loading the Scada file, it's going to load all the files that are required to flash the mobile phone. Right now I do not want to lose any data, so I'm gonna discheck this option saying user data. I don't want to overwrite it. I want to keep all the data that was inside on the phone, but I want the phone to have a new firmware without removing the data. Okay, what I'm gonna do right now that the software is open, I'm going to click download. The tool is already on download mode. Then I'm gonna connect the USB cable to the phone and put the battery. Okay, at this point the download should start. If it doesn't start, then the Windows is going to load the drivers first automatically, then the download process is going to start. But make sure that the phone doesn't start charging, because if it starts charging, then it means it's not working. You need to disconnect the cable and redo the process. Okay. Connect the cable, then put the battery in. If it keeps disconnecting, you need to disconnect the USB cable and connect it to a different port. That's just what I'm going to do here. I'm changing the port and repeat the process. I'll stop download and reload the tool. Okay, this is not an easy task. You better be very careful when playing with this tool, because you might end up damaging your phone if you do not know what you're doing. So I'll repeat the process. I'll connect the cable and connect the battery in. Okay, now the flashing process has just started. Make sure that you do not disturb the USB cable, because this process should not be terminated. If you terminate this process before it finishes, you might end up damaging your phone. So this is very much important. And another thing that's very important you need to be cautious about, before you can even start flashing your phone, make sure that the battery has at least 50% of capacity. Then you can start flashing. If it has less than that, you are posing a threat of having your phone switch off before it completes flashing. That will damage the phone too. When the phone is damaged by installing a firmware and it end up not booting, that is called hard brick. There are two types of bricks. There is hard brick, there is soft brick. Hard brick is when the hardware is damaged. Soft brick, it is when the software is damaged. Usually soft brick can be fixed, but hard brick cannot be fixed unless you are highly skilled in mobile phone repair and you have a tool called mobile reworkstation. So the tool that I'm using right here is called mobile reworkstation. So you can use this tool to remove the EMMC chip on the phone and throw it away. Then you can replace with another EMMC. That's a complex process and it's a bit expensive. So the best thing is to ensure that the battery capacity of your phone stays on reaches 50% or above, then you can start the flashing process. Okay, right now it's on 57% and it's going. Once it's reached 100%, it's going to disconnect the phone automatically. This process can not only be used to install a new firmware, or let me say this tool cannot be only used to install a new firmware. You can also use to update a firmware that's already installed in your phone. For example, you can download a new firmware, Android firmware, then load it on this tool. Then you have to go to updates. Right here I clicked download only because I do not want to upgrade to a new version. This version of firmware that I loaded here is the same version that is loaded on this phone, just that it's got damaged, so I need to restore it. Other than that, this tool can also be used to reset FRP, like I showed you with the Samsung. You can format specific memory blocks using this tool and get rid of passwords and other securities. But you must do that only if you know what you're doing, because you can format something called calibration data. When formatting calibration data, your phone will be bricked too. Okay, now it's reached 100%, and when it says download okay, it's actually finished. You can close the tool, then the flashing process is complete. Thank you for watching this video.